we have a little extra surprise for you today because we have not only Delfeayo Marsalis, but the members of his group. So you're going to get a little extra with your book reading today. And I would tell you, there were several of us in the audience that saw the band perform last night. Those of you who missed a really great treat. But I think you're in for a big treat today. And what we'd like to do is invite the parents with their children. If you'd like to come up here and sit on the floor and get a little bit closer in the audience, would you like to do that? Please do. And nobody's too old. If you feel like you can get down on the floor and get back up again, please join us. So part of what we're doing today is kicking off a book that Delfeayo's written. So he's not only an accomplished musician, but now he's a published author. So his book is called No Cell Phone Day. So anybody who has your cell phone, it better be turned off and put away. This is No Cell Phone Day at the museum. And I also wanted to let you know that Delfeayo has a foundation called the Kids Uptown Music Theater. And I'm going to let him talk to you about that for a couple minutes, and we'll get the program started. So thank you all for coming.
Thank you, Ms. Carroll. Hello, boys and girls. Hello, boys and girls. Did you not eat your Wheaties today? Hello, boys and girls. All right. I'm Delfeayo Marsalis, and it is true we have the Uptown Music Theater. I have a younger brother. His name is Mboya. He was named for an African politician, Tom Mboya. And he was born 1970. Mboya has autism. And this was back before there was a lot of knowledge about autism. So hanging out with my younger brother Mboya inspired me to help youngsters and kids. And I've always had various programs, and I volunteered at Children's Hospital when I was a Boy Scout. I had to get my merit badges. So it's always important to me that we continue to help out, and we learn a lot from hanging out with the youngsters also. I learn every time I'm able to be around some youngsters. So in 2000, I formed the Uptown Music Theater, and the idea was to give New Orleans youth the opportunity to study the dramatic arts. So because of that, I've composed 15 or 16 musicals, and some of them are history plays. Like, we did one on the 60s, we did one on Althea Gibson, we have one on Duke Ellington, and we also do plays that we like. We have a pirate show, we have something on New Tale of the Old West, something on Storyville, G-rated. So I decided one day, at my daughter's urging, when she was 8 years old, that we would spend an entire day without the cell phone. And she told everybody, well, you like that, huh? She told everybody. She was excited. We're having a no cell phone day. We're having a no cell phone day. She called everybody she knew. We're having a no cell phone day. So we had a no cell phone day, and it inspired me to write the story. So pretty much wrote the story. I was traveling one time on the plane, and I wrote it down. And then we revised it with a great illustrator with great illustrations. And that's what we do. So we're happy to present to you No Cell Phone Day. I want to invite my musicians have been gracious enough to donate their time. We have Richard Johnson on the piano. Marquise Hill on the trumpet. Eric Wheeler on the stand-up bass. Renard Harper on the drums. All right, so we're just making this up as we go along. No, it's okay. It's fine.
It's fine.
We love the enthusiasm. How old is she? 16 months. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. We're going to have a good time. So this is kind of an impromptu version instead of just reading the book. Thank you. Instead of just reading, we're going to play some music and we'll also read and we'll see what happens. All right.
Thank you. All right. Oh, here we go. No Cell Phone Day, written by me. Illustrated by Reginald William Butler. My dad loves his cell phone. In fact, he even has two. So he can check emails and texts on one while he talks on the other. Seems like the only time he isn't on his cell phone is when he's playing tennis, driving, or taking a bath. In the morning, he starts off the day with a quick read of the latest news blogs in case something big happened while we were asleep. If I didn't already tell you, my dad has a real important job. People text him all the time for the right answers and the latest sports scores. This year, Mom and I planned a special surprise for Dad's birthday. We wrote down a list of things to do and places to go all around the city on an adventure that we call, what's it called? No Cell Phone Day. That morning, Dad looked through the whole house two times over before he finally asked, has anyone seen my cell phone? Surprise, Mom said, as I gave him the card we made. I have to let you guys know, my 12-year-old daughter actually drew this card. She didn't want to do it. I had to insist. It took her like 10 minutes. I was like, I wanted to I called out directions as Dad drove down Carondelet Street and turned right by the St. Charles streetcar tracks. Camellia Grill is best known for their fluffy, golden brown, you guessed it, waffles. But the waffle iron was broken, so I ordered the banana sponge cakes a la mode. Pancakes, bananas, ice cream, syrup, cinnamon, and whipped cream. Only in New Orleans can you eat breakfast and dessert at the same time. Dad laughed as he ordered the breakfast special. Three pecan whipped pancakes, three eggs, praline bacon, sausage, grits on hash browns, orange juice, tea or coffee. You gotta love New Orleans. Anybody is dead coming from New Orleans. While we were in the restaurant, someone's cell phone rang. Dad looked up in a hurry. He checked his pockets and on the table. Daddy, I shouted. For the most part, though, Dad didn't mind at all not having his cell phone. We talked about all kinds of things, including our summer plans. I'm going to Canada, I've got something to do here. Dad's taking a business trip to Taiwan. Guess what else? Dad, Mom, and I are going on a family vacation to Hawaii. Aloha! Breakfast was delicious, and our day was awesome.
Cell phone battery was dead.
got a list of things to do on your little cell phone day. The end.
Thank you.
If anyone has any questions for me or any of the guys in the band, we're here, we have a couple more minutes, and we're happy to. And if there's no questions, you know, cool, we'll just go eat.